Hi, and welcome to the 12th video about our DevSecOps pipeline, which we are building with GitLab. And this is now our final video where we are going to share with you our recommendation and our summary of this pipeline. In our past 11 videos, we built up this DevSecOps pipeline with GitLab. In our first two videos, we have shown you what exactly GitLab is and how to set up a new project.
Then we've dived into software composition analysis, so finding vulnerabilities in dependencies.
Then we enabled license compliance check, so that we can find issues with licenses.
We added static application security testing, meaning finding vulnerabilities or security issues in your own code.
Then we enabled container scanning, where we're scanning our containers for security vulnerabilities.
Next, we introduced secret detection, where we scanned all our code for secrets like passwords that we accidentally added.
Then we enabled dynamic application security testing, which is basically a penetration test on the running application.
We've leveraged merge requests to tell us what security impact changes have.
And in the end, we introduced scheduled pipeline, where we can define a schedule where the pipeline runs on the production code so that we can find new vulnerabilities that have been identified in the meantime. And now, Padi, what did we learn in our DevSecOps journey?
There's a couple of things we actually learned and we have as a recommendation for you prepared. Define the default branch for your project. This is the branch that's relevant for vulnerability management. This is where you will see all results from the security tools.
Then we learned that when you have code in production, you also need to scan this code for new found vulnerabilities. We do that by using scheduled pipeline, where we are going to execute the pipeline on a regular basis and execute some of our security tests.
We also recommend to use merge requests whenever you bring code into the default branch. This is to find newly introduced security issues with the new changes. If required, define approvers that are allowed to accept new issues.
We also saw that you should never ever store your secrets in your source code. To identify secrets that have been introduced in the source code or in configuration files, we use secret detection. Use a vault to store your secrets. GitLab recommends to use HashiCorp Vault and it has great integration into that.
We also learned that using out-of-the-box GitLab-provided tooling is best for easy integration and for maintenance. If you need to use your own tools, this will be considerable effort. In the case of the dynamic application security testing, remember that you need to customize the scanner. Without proper customization, results will be very limited. So plan time to do that.
And as you can see, the whole topic of DevSecOps pipeline is quite complex. There are many tools involved when you build up your DevSecOps pipeline. To deal with this complexity, I recommend always to include a security expert so that you can discuss how you are going to set up your pipeline, how to configure all the tools, which tools to use and which steps to introduce, and how to manage your security vulnerabilities.
Well, and this concludes our sessions about DevSecOps and creating a DevSecOps pipeline in GitLab.
And with that, we are at the end of this video. Please stay tuned, because we will do another series about the same DevSecOps pipeline, now with GitHub. See you soon.